Okay, this is one of their buddies that went in here with them. They died. So we open the door. And this is why we're here. Get DC internal medicine, Batman, and this. T-51B power armor. Hells yeah. And so that counts as completing the quest, so I get the experience for it and everything. So now I'm really fat. Big Book of Science. Here, I want to show you one spot. I went in here, I kind of cheated, and I unlocked doors that were very hard. But in here, there's a guns and bullets. I can't get it, and that makes me sad. And there wasn't anything cool that I can recall. So yeah, I'm missing guns and bullets. There's like a, not a secret way out, but there's a fast way out up here. You had to get that key from that Terra's body, and I can get out faster. Dead. Assassinated. Yeah, in here, this is a different building entirely, actually. Yeah, I'll leave. Actually, I'll open this, I guess. See, I'll go back and make a dart gun. Then I'm done. Let's grab more. Capital Wasteland. See, open with Warhead Storage Key. Oh shit. Mr. Gussie right frickin' there. Yes. Yeah, now if you go back and talk to Mr. Crowley, he's pissed at you. He's like, you sold me out, or something. There's a bunch of cards here. There's also a random event spot here. So yeah. Here's actually Fort Constantine.
But
over
the Shepherd
here.
Of Vault 101 has come to guide you to the promised land.
Maybe yeah, you can get up on top of here and there's bad guys.
Know what I've decided, children? I'm gonna start a book club.
He's gonna start a book club.
Now, wanna join? Good, because you got no choice. Our first masterpiece is called Wasteland Survival Guide. Written by Megaton's own, Moira Brown. Oh, and get this. Researched and co-authored by none other than, yep, you guessed it, that audacious teenager from Vault 101. Now, let me tell you, this thing's got all sorts of useful tips. Where to find food, how to deal with radiation, tons of stuff.
It's just, this has got to be so annoying for them. Keep getting hit over and over and keep getting knocked down.
The book is the Wasteland Survival Guide.
Oh, shit.
Pick up your copy today.
Thanks for your copy today. I'm gonna pay him with this.
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here.
Yep, okay, I'm good. Back to Megaton.
Now, some music.
Deposit my sexy armor. It's not really that sexy. What gun should I use? The old Painless. I'm gonna peg him right in the eye. Bam. This gun's pretty good. It shoots hella fast. I mostly like it for its really good accuracy, though. Here, let me show you something. You can jump off and, like, not take any fall damage. If you do it right. Oh, crap. I didn't get close enough. Yeah! Ninja noises. Insert ninja noises here. Let's see if he dies from the after damage. Yeah, he did. You suck. I probably have so much flamer fuel. Let's remove my thing. So quests, we have... God, I have too many quests. We're gonna do Into the Pit, though. And once we get back, I'm finding dog meat. And then, I don't know what we're gonna do when I get back from the pit.
Boy, do I breathe a lot easier, knowing that thing is truly dead.
That's cool. Okay. Cannot resist. Shut up, Lucas Sims. Yep. Did I kill Tenpenny? I think I killed him. No, I didn't. I left him alive so that I could kill him at a later occasion. Because he messed up my mama's girl parts. I'm so clever. So what do I need? I need a red scorpion poison gland, surgical tubing, toy car, toy boat. Let's make a bunch. Dart gun, dart gun, dart gun, dart gun, dart gun. Not enough paint things. Now you can see the dart gun. Dude, these dart guns, right? Look, right leg minus 1,000, left leg minus 1,000. HP minus 8 HP per second for 8 seconds. And it does a little bit of damage on its own. So, it's a good opener for the soul factor of the poison. But not a good opener, because you want to sneak attack with a weapon that does more damage. But after your sneak attack, it's a very good weapon to start with, because of the poison. And it's especially useful, because it cripples both legs. That makes everything easier. Everything. Even if it's not, like, a Deathclaw or something. Even if it's, I don't know. It helps against anything. Even Enclave troops. Because, you know, against Enclave troops, it's actually pretty good, because of the poison, because they have a lot of armor. You do that, you just hide around the corner, you can take pot shots at them. And yeah, of course, the poison doesn't work on non-organic units like robots, but I still think it cripples their legs, if they have legs. Like, obviously, Enclave iBots don't have legs. But yeah. So yeah, woo! Next time, Into the Pit. Dun-dun-dun. Oh, I forgot to turn off the recording. Haha. Into the Pit.